ancestor of our present day dog. Now coming to the breathing management, we have to have some of the knowledges regarding their reproductive traits. So here, as at puberty or maturity, it comes at around 6 to 12 months. As at breeding is above 1 year of age, after 1 and 6 months, 5 years. Estrus cycle, type of the estrus cycle is monoestrus, or sometimes it may be 2 estrus in a year. Length of the estrus cycle is 6 months. Length of the estrus, that is the heat, 6 to 13 days. Gestation period, average is 63 days, around 2 months. Time of ovulation, 48 to 60 hours, means after 2 days after receptive phase, that is after mating, that ovulation takes place. Then if we are going for artificial insemination, then the proper time or the right time is 2 to 3 days after onset of the true estrus. Breeding season, biennial, mainly August to September or February to March. Return of the heat after parturation, after giving young ones, then they used to come into heat again after 16 to 20 weeks, that is 4 months to 5 months around. Recurrence after non-conception, twice yearly. Age at weaning, 4 to 6 months, 6 weeks, that is around 1 or 1.5 months, the pups can be weaned out from the mother. Time of fertilized ova inter uterus, 5 to 6 days post mating. Then time of fertilized ova entering uterus. Once this ova are fertilized, then they come into the uterus after around 5 to 6 days. Time of implantation begins, 15 days post mating. Type of placenta, endothelial. Expulsion of placenta immediately after its fetus, it means if one pup is born, then fetus, that placenta is also expelled out. Then average number of pups born, there is average litter size, 4 to 8 pups. Birth weight around 65 gram to 500 gram, depending upon the type of the breed, large breed, medium breed or small breed. Breeding span, 7 to 8 years. Lifespan in most of the dog is around 10 to 15 years. Now coming to the puberty, as I already mentioned, the dog attains puberty at around 6 to 12 months of age, depending on the type of the breed, plan of nutrition, and the managemental practices. Generally, small breed attain faster their maturity as compared to that of the large breeds. However, in few breeds, even after 20 to 24 months of age, they may not be in heat, means they may take longer time. Then in the pre-living stray dogs, the dogs which you are observing on the roadside and all, their puberty, it comes earlier. As compared to males, females mature earlier. Then the bitch should not be bred during their first heat, that is first season, because they are not mature physically. Then males become fertile after around 6 months of age, and the full sexual maturity is after around 1 year. Then healthy stud dogs or breeding dogs may remain sexually active and fertile even in the old age also. Then coming to the estrus cycles of the bitch, here there are 4 periods. The first is pro-estrus. It lasts for about 9 days. During this period, the bitch may attract the males, but they are not ready to accept the male. Then coming to the next, that is the estrus. During this period, the bitch will accept the male and is fertile. They are fertile in this particular period. Then ovulation usually occurs in the first 48 hours, that is in the first 2 days. Coming to the diesters, it lasts around 2 to 3 months, that is 60 to 90 days. This is the period when the reproductive tract is under the control of the hormone progesterone. You might have heard this hormone progesterone, which is responsible for gestation. This occurs whether or not the bitch becomes pregnant. Sometimes if the bitch is pregnant, also if not pregnant also, this period will be there. Then if they are not pregnant, that is known as, but behaving just like a pregnant bitch, that is known as false pregnancy or pseudo pregnancy. Then any stress here, they are not active sexually and it may last 3 to 4 months. Then before going for breeding, actual breeding, what we should do, the bitch should be checked for its health conditions. That is known as pre-breeding health checkups for bitch. Around 1 month before the breeding, expected time of breeding, the bitch should be examined for its conditions, like whether she is vaccinated properly, and testing and the treatment for parasitic infestation, if any, then testing of the brucellosis, a bacterial disease which causes abortion in case of cattle, and here also they may cause sterility or abortion. Then screening for genetic problems, like is there any genetically inherited abnormalities in the animal. Then coming for the male side, what we should do is there should be free from any genetic abnormalities. Otherwise, it may be inherited in your pups, and they should be tested for brucellosis also. Then vaccination schedule, whether it is up to date or not for the male side. Now coming to once this medical checkup or veterinary checkup or evaluation or examination is over, then we will go for the stress detection of the female side. A bit in heat, they may show this one, sometimes public nauseance due to their hormonal changes. And she is undesirable at home and welcome to the abroad also, means outside area also. During this period, the vulva of the bitch is swelled up, and there may be some discharge, the bloody discharge may be there. Then it may continue for 8 to 10 days or even maybe a little longer. Then during this period, males may be attracted towards the female, but female will not accept the males. Then after this period, there is the bloody discharge and all, then there will be a pinkish or watery discharge for some more days. Then during this period, the female will show the behavior of rising the tail, tilted in one side, and they will be receptive to the male. So this is the time for actual breeding. That heat period may last for 21 days. Then, when we talk about the different types of breed, that detection of heat may be easier in case of short-coated breeds. If the dog breed is having a long hair type, then we may not be able to observe the swelling in the vulva and all, but swelling of the floor or staining of the floor are the indicatives of the heat. Now here, once the animal, the bitch is receptive of the male, then mating will take place here. What we should do is, about the bitch, we should have this information, that is length of the proestrus, estrus, diestrus of the previous breeding seasons, whether the bitch was having any pseudo pregnancy, any abnormal cycle, then any disease condition in the vagina, and the complete health record is required about the bitch. Then when the female is in heat, she is receptive, that time she may be taken to the male, that is the breeding male of your choice. How, and it is advisable that the female should be taken to the male prior to the breeding for their acclimatization. So this will give them ample time to get settled, that is familiarity. Then mating may take place after 1 or 2 days, when they are brought together, that is when the female is brought to the male side, then this may be the 10 to 13 days after the onset of the Easter cycle in larger breeds and maybe earlier in smaller breeds. Means after 10 to 13 days of the estrus, then the female may accept the male. Then once this mating takes place, we should diagnose the female, that is the bead, whether she is pregnant or not. First condition is the clinical signs of the pregnancy appear in a bead about 25 to 30 days, that is around 1 month of the mating. Common signs are there may be loss of appetite, nausea, tendency of vomiting, and there may be loss of the appetite. Then after around 5 weeks, there is around 30 plus, means around 40 days, there may be significant increase in the appetite of the bees. Then during the last 2 weeks of gestation, fetus can be easily palpated. You can palpate in the abdominal area. Then we can use radiography, ultrasonic scanning for identification, even for this number of piglets also. Then once the bitch is found to be pregnant, then we have to take care of her. Generally, this gestation period is around 1 or 2 months. So during the first month of pregnancy, the normal maintenance diet is adequate. Then give additional diet. It is good to add even a liver in the diet at the rate of 1 gram per kg body weight. Eggs, dairy products, and other good quality animal proteins can be given, and the minerals and the vitamin supplements to the pregnant bees. Then immunization against distemper, that is known as one canine distemper, and the hepatitis during the mid gestation period. Then deworming also should be done during the mid gestation period. Then once this, after the completion of around 50, 60 days, then we should be ready for the whelping of the bees. Here, there will be temperamental changes in the bees. The vulva swells up, the mammary glands become turgid, and the milk will exude on squeezing the teeth. The bees will seek a safe and a calm behavior is there, then you should come to know that the bitch is now about to whelp. Then when the uterine contraction starts, that is the first stage, the female dog behave abnormally due to the pain, restless, growing and refusing, even they will stop eating. She will lie down in one side and will strain heavily. The discharge is greenish in color and is thin. Greenish. When the stage of the labor begins, leave it to herself. The pup may be presented either alone or with the placenta attached to the umbilicus. Once the pup is born, the bees will beat it off and may eat the umbilicus. Then at times the whole bag is presented, the bees may not care to open it. Sometimes what happened, the pup is inside the bag. So in that situation, what we should do is we have to break the bag and just take out the pups. After the littering of around 1 or 2 pups, the bees may be quiescent for some time. She may take some rest and will start again straining and will give another 1 or 2 pups like that. Once the whelping of whole number of pups are completed, it may take around 18 hours, even maybe more than that. Cords may be painted and antiseptic, ligated and cut off if it is very long. Passing of the upper body, that is placenta, one for each. Once a pup is born, placenta is also passed out. Then that way, it goes on till the completion of all the pups. Then keep all those pups warm. Then many bitches will not feed or drink till the littering is complete. Here, during this whelping time, she may not eat anything or may not drink also. After completion of the whelping, drinking milk, it may be there, and she may chew solid food. Then during this whelping time, you should avoid any strangers, not to disturb her. And this is the photograph here, some of the pups, young, newly born pups here. Then here again, along with their mother, this suckling. And sometimes there may be problem at the time of whelping, then the bitch is unable to give the normal birth to their young ones. So during this period, you should be very careful. If the whelping, that is the standing started, but unable to give any of the pups, maybe even after 3-4 hours, then you should consult a veterinarian. So then sometimes what happened, the bitch may behave as if she is pregnant after the mating. So she will develop this one abdominal size, then mammary gland development will be there, everything. But that situation of the bees where she is behaving as if a pregnant bees, that is known as pseudo pregnancy or false pregnancy. Then how to care of these young pups here? The pups will open their eyes after 2nd week. Then flooring there, if the floor is very smooth, they may not be able to raise up because there will be no grip to walk. So it is better to put them in the rough ground. And this may be necessary for another 2 or 3 days till they learn how to walk. Then supplements for vitamins, especially A, B, D, E, and C, and the minerals like calcium and phosphorus during pre-weaning stage may be provided. If the litter size is large, means more number of pups are there, we have to take care of their feeding in a separate bottle. Pups will full stomach and not crying during the night is the indication of having enough food. Otherwise, they may cry in the night. And docking and amputation, if necessary, may be done during the pre-weaning stage. Then newborn should spend the majority of their time sleeping. What is the behavior of the newborn one? Most of the time, they are sleeping. Once they are awake, they will go for nursing, that is suckling. Then 75% of their time they spend in sleeping, and this is characterized by, even though they are sleeping also, there is some behavioral activities like continual twitching, jerking, stressing, and shifting of positions, means as if they are not sleeping a sound sleep. Then activated sleep is important for the development of the neuromuscular system and appears to be mechanism by which newborn puppies develop muscle tone and begin to develop coordination. So this type of activities during the sleep also, so that is useful for their neuromuscular system development. Most important indications for puppies' health is during the first few days of their life, that is, they should have a normal and a regular weight gain. Then after the day 2 or 3 days, puppies should steadily increase in weight and they may become double of their weight by 7 to 10 days. It means around after 1 week, they may have double of their birth weight. General thumb of rule is the weight gain during the first 3 to 4 weeks of life is expected to be 1 gram of gain per day. Then puppies typically, I mean, the weaning age is around 6 to 8 weeks, that is around 40-45 days. Then lactation, whether the bitch is giving proper amount of milk or not during this stage, the bitch is under tremendous stress of the lactations. Her nutrient requirements will be more. The diet should be rich in protein and is easily digestible. And at least they should be given 3 to 4 times feeding in a day. Then we should provide clean drinking water, supplementation of mineral vitamins. They are also required. Then even after providing so much of these additional nutrients also, the bitch will drain out of her physical conditions, means they will become lean and thin. And the mammary gland, sometimes there will be numerous abrasions due to the suckling. And we should provide or continue to provide this mineral and vitamin even after the weaning of the pups also. So that's all. This is the breathing management of the dogs. I will provide you people this hands out in this WhatsApp group. Now I will go for another lecture, that is classification of dog for today. Now the next topic is classification of cat breeds, and here I am no expert of cat breeds. So here cats are very cosmopolitan and found everywhere in the world, and free ranging cats, that is generally the wild type cats, they are very active both at night and the day, and more active during the night times. Then house cats are more active during morning and evening times. Then they used to conserve their energy by sleeping in most of the time, particularly if they are aged. The average sleeping times in case of cat is 13 to 14 hours. Then house cat, that is the cat which we are rearing as a pet animals, they used to spend most of the time in the vicinity of their home. They don't go out. Even if they are going out of the home also, they are in the 100 or 200 meters circumference. They used to send rubbing or spraying their urine as a primary behavior to claim ownership, as in the wild animals. Mostly male cat spray and the female cat do not spray. When male cat is neuter, that is sterilized, the scent rubbing or the spraying will stop. So here are the photographs, how they are doing their spraying of the urine and all to claim their territorial area. Now this coming to the characteristics of the cats here. Eyes. Their eyes, they have the characteristics of this one. That capacity to see even in the dim light also. And they have a very wide binocular vision that is even up to 120 degree. Then olfactory, cat has about 200 million scent receptor in the nose, slightly higher than that of dogs. As compared to dogs, that cat has more number of scent receptors. Then vomeronasal organ, that is also known as Jacobson's organs, is found in the roof of the mouth. In the mouth, once it is open in the roof side, that upper side, and it comprises of a pair of small fluid-filled sacs. Then the purpose of this is, it is used in the feline courtship and the sexual behavior. And this will enable them to identify and recognize other cats and peoples. The phlegmon response as observed in case of cattle and other animals are also exhibited in case of cat during courtship. Then auditory, here they can detect sounds within a very wide range, Human can hear up to 20,000 cycles per second. Cats can detect up to 60,000 to 80,000 cycles per second, like 3 to 4 times. And whiskers or vibrissae, it is present here, a long hairs at the nostril area here in the mouth area, those are present here. And again, a type of hairs also, carpal hairs known as on the back of the front wrist, that they are 4 limbs. These characteristics are very sensitive to ear currents, and it provides sensory information about the precise position of the head and the legs. And it also helps in the movement in the dim light. The whiskers are also known to protect the face and the eyes by conveying information about the objects close to the face. So these are the importance of the whiskers. Then coming to the types of the cat breeds here, they are classified specially on the basis of their body size, the basis of their coat type. So here we'll discuss the types of cat on the basis of their size. So first is large size cat breeds here. The names are American bobtail cat, American short hair cat, British short hair cat, Somali cat, Himalayan cat, Siamese cat, exotic short hair cat, Maine Coon cat. So one by one, let us see here. As the name indicates, American bobtail cat, they are medium to large size. Coat is short, medium and long. Lifespan generally 13 to 15 years. But here is the name itself says that bobtail means the tail is very short. It is a genetic effect. And again, in case of Japanese bobtail also, they also have a very short tail. The type of genes and these particular characters, they are different. There is in American bobtail, it is dominant in nature. In case of Japanese bobtail cat, that is a recessive in nature. Then here, they are very athletic and they have a dog-like tendencies also. These are the photographs of the American bobtail. Now coming to the American short hair cat, the name itself says it is a short hair type. They are also medium to large. Coat is very short, as the name indicates. Then origin is North America, and believed to be a descendant from European cats brought to North America by early settlers to protect valuable cargo from mice and the rats. So these were these breed reached to America from Europe. Then coming to the British short hair cat here, they are medium to large, and coat type is short, the name says. And they have different types of colors. Then coming to the Somali cat here, origin is Somalia. Coat is medium, fine and soft. And it is very beautiful. And generally, this Somali is essentially considered as a long hair version of the Abyssinian. Abyssinian is a small type cat breed. Then Himalayan cat, the nickname is Himi. Here, origins are from USA, UK, and India. Then color comes generally in white to fawn body with various colors. And Siamese cat, hair type is short and comes in the silk point and chocolate point color, and blue also that is there. It comes from Thailand. And this breed is considered as one of the first distinctly recognized breeds of Asian cat. Coming to the exotic short hair cat here, its origin is from USA, and it is a crossbred, means the cat breeders, they developed this breed by crossing of the American short hair, Persian cat, Burmese occasionally, and the Russian blue also. So Russian blue will be coming up in the slides, which will show later on. Then Maine Coon cat. Here it is originated from Maine, USA. Coat type is short. And most common color is brown tail, but other colors also may be there. And this breed is one of the oldest natural breeds in North America, especially native to the USA state of Maine, where it is the official state cat. Then coming to the small size cat breeds here, they are Abyssinian, American Corgi, Cornish Rex, Devon Rex, Oriental, Peterbald, Russian Blue, Singapura. So coming to this Abyssinian cat, they are small type, origins, Ethiopia, that is Southeast Asia, core type is medium. And this, the breed is named for Abyssinia, now called Ethiopia, where it is believed to have originated. Now, American Curl Cat here, they are small type, origin is USA, coat is short, color comes in white, black, and other colors also. And one characteristic of this American Curl Cat, the name says, name indicates that the ear, they are curved back from the face towards the center of the skull. See the photograph here. And therefore, their ears should be handled very carefully, not to break the cartilage of the ear. Then Cornish Rex cat here, origin is from United Kingdom, UK. Coat type is extremely soft and silky. Color comes generally in black, blue. And Devon Rex cat, they are also small size, origin is England. Then a breed of cat which is currently very soft, short type hair and similar to that of Cornish Rex cat. Then it comes in a varieties of color, white, blue, black. Then characteristics are tall ear. Ear is very tall or long. Then they are known for their slender bodies, long slender bodies. And the Devon should never be brushed because her fur is too fragile. Here one characteristic is their fur should not be groomed. Then coming to the Oriental cat here, they are from United States and Thailand. There may be two types, short hair and long hair. And coat colors are generally blue, chestnut. Then Russian blue cat, the name says that it is a blue color cat. And hair is short, dense. And these are the photographs here. Then Singapura cat and smallest domestic cat breeds. This one is known as smallest domestic cat breeds. It is from Singapore. Coat is short, fine, and silky. Here, this particular breed of cat has only one type of color, that is brown, thick, and ugly. Then coming to the same size cat breeds, Bengal cat, Burmese cat, Bombay cat, Japanese bobtail cat, European Burmese cat, Egyptian Mau cat. So Bengal cat here, they are medium in size, origin is USA, and here the name Bengal, it looks like that it is from our West Bengal or Bengal. No, it is from USA. Then foundation bloodstock are Egyptian Mau, Abyssinian and others domestic Asian leopard cat. So due to this, some genetic inheritance from the leopard, it looks like a wild cat, that sport patterns and all, see the photographs. Then Burmese cat, it originated from Burma, near the Thailand and the Burma border. Now it is called Myanmar. Coat type is short, and coat colors are sable, chimpanzee, blue, platinum, different types of coat colors are there. Coming to the Bombay cat, and it is not from the Bombay, India. It is from United States and Thailand. And it was developed by breeding sable, Burmese, and the black American short hair cats to produce a cat of mostly Burmese type, but with a sleek panther-like black coat. So they are totally black in color. Japanese bobtail cat here, as in American bobtail cat, here also tails, the length is very short, but the genes controlling this trait is recessive in nature, and it is considered as one of the oldest cat breed in the world. Coming to the European Burmese cat here, their medium hair type is short, and colors generally they are brown, chocolate, or blue. Then there is one difference between these Burmese cat and the European Burmese cat. They are, both of them are having the genetic inheritance from the Burmese breed, but the European Burmese cat, they are having rounded contours, whereas the Burmese has a compact and a well-rounded appearance. Then eye type here, there is some difference in the eye also. The Burmese, European Burmese cat, they have a slight curve at the top line in the eyes with a slant towards the nose. The lower line should be rounded, but whereas in case of Burmese eyes, the eyes are rounded in nature. So some differences there due to their differences in the genetic background. Otherwise, names are almost same, Burmese cat and the European Burmese cat. Then Egyptian mau cat here, it is from Egypt, as the name says. The colors are silver, bronze, and smoke. Then the coat type is short to medium. So this is the end of this different type of cat breeds. So in the next class, I will take that selection of the cat breeds as a pet animals and some major characteristics of the. In detail, I will be again giving their temperament, their grooming, their health conditions of these different breeds. Here is simply classification. Cats are classified on the basis of their body size, on the basis of their hair coat type. Coats may be short or long. So here what I have given is only on the basis of the body weight, that some background knowledge you should have about the cats. Okay, here I am winding up your class today here, but I want to know from you people, you please switch on your this one. Hello, anyone?
Yes, sir.
Why so many of you are not in the class? Is there anything from your friends, any news? Even these, your numbers are even less than the 50%. Is it due to the internet problem or else they are not joining intentionally?
So network issue.
Network issue may be there, but I don't think there are so many students may be having that network issue. Because when we take the exams, all of you were responding. But in the class, maybe 5-10 students, or even 15 students, they may have the problem of the network. But here, most of the time, many of the students, they are not joining the class. See, they are not asking about anything also in the WhatsApp group or any other things. Are due to the network problem, they could not join class, these things, that things. Anyway, okay, and all the best again. I am winding up here your class today. Okay, bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, welcome.
Thank you, sir.